Then I jump in the shower, so the bladder start pumping, and out on the street the traffic car's thumping, like folks like me on a job from 9 to 5. You build your dreams just to watch them shatter. You're just a step on the boss man's ladder, but you've got dreams he'll never take away. Cause, I mean, you're in the same boat as a lot of your friends, waiting for the day your ship will come in. But then the tide's gonna turn and it's all gonna blow away. But once again, my creative daydream would be interrupted by the ever-watching eyes of the management. See, like a child spinning in circles just to make himself dizzy, my only requirement in that place was to make sure I look busy. But I'm using that to my advantage, you see, because just as not every open eye is seeing, not every closed eye is sleeping, so why they pay me for this painted by numbers shit, every thought I have I'm keeping. And I'm using this to my advantage, see, because I just did that line. Fuck. And remember, the Swedish shit can taste pretty different if they season it right. So if you're going to sell out your beliefs, make sure your reasons are watertight. And as the chief worker bee tries his best to nurture me and searches deep to help me find the key that might just unlock and help me free the buried in the bourgeoisie that with time and effort I can someday be secure a place of great integrity, rooted deep in the company's family tree, taking bullet point steps from A to Z, leaping over the boring pass like a corporate flea. I look at my supposed luminary and I simply don't agree. Hell, I'll sell my soul. I'm just waiting for an appropriate thing. Ain't no penny loafer wearing fuck gonna shortchange me. Scroobius PRP to la DRE. So fuck it, I'm back in the rap race again. But that's cool, because amongst these rats I found some straight up true friends. And I've started drawing my own map. You ain't believe where this shit ends. Ah shit, I'm back in the rap race again.